Right, well, I'm here with Sean from, what's the name of your studio again?
Autopsy Records Seattle. Start from the top and just kind of go down. We have a pair of the Steven Slate Pro Audio Dragons. These are really cool. They look kind of like an 1176 compressor, but they're not quite. They're partially an 1176, and they're partially a preamp that's based on a Neve and MCI 5K, so a Neve 1073 MCI 5K. And you just press, flip it over, and flip it back, and you can change all the little fun coloring options on it. Next we have the Orion, which is running everything into it. So that's the brains of the operation. That's kind of like our tape machine. Makes everything analog talk to the computer. Our Manly mid-frequency EQ, which is a wonderful Pultec unit that I picked up. These things are all hand-built in Chino. I love them. They're great on guitars. They're great on vocals for really cutting in the EQ. Bluey, of course, designed by Chris Lord-Alge. And the wonderful people over at Black Lion Audio. They're absolutely brilliant. Vintage Pultec HLF 3C, so this is the high-low cut filter. These things are super rare now. This thing's coming out of the 60s, but very cool device. Of course, a 160A, which everybody has. Focusrite Optical, which I use sometimes for mastering purposes. Lesis Acura, which is another one that is really fun for stereo effect. Of course, the Ibanez multi-modes for your analog delay. The 166 is just basically a 160A in stereo. And then, of course, down to the Feast of Resistance, the 120X DS. So this is actually a really fun piece. This came out of the Sylvia Massey Studios. And the way that kind of went about is I had some friends that had worked with Sylvia in the past, and so they get me in contact with her occasionally for things that she's selling off from various phases, I guess, of her career, from working with System of a Down or working with Tool. So this piece in particular came off of the Opiate and Undertow album sessions, and what it does is it takes all the low subsonic frequencies and all the subharmonics, and it allows you to boost them up to a point where, so when you're listening to those first two Tool records, if you listen to the kick drum or the bass guitar, you'll notice that they're really, really intense. They're just really getting into it, and it's this that's actually making that possible. Use this guy running it through, apologize for the Chinese food and the booze, but so you start the chain up here and you'll run your microphone out into this LA4 compressor, and this will get it that nice punchy snappy fast attack that you want, and then you'll run this out into the 120 via the patch bay. And that's kind of the sort of the short and skinny. Obviously we have plenty of fun stuff to play with around here. We just got our monitor section set up the other day. So the wonderful Avatone powered mix cubes, they sound absolutely brilliant. And then of course, the D8 Exposés. Course, we have our SSL X-Logix, so we're running 16 channels of preamp for SSL Solid State Duality. These are beautiful preamps. Coming into our Malcolm Toft, this is actually going to be going away next week. We did find it a new home, thankfully. Then we'll come over here and running into our Stereo G Comp, our glue bus, if you will, and then our LA2A, our Meyer sound that's been modified by the wonderful people at Revive Audio, and of course a stereo pair of distressors with the ELA-X British mode. These things are kick-ass. Coming over here, whiskey bar. Drums, of course, we have a custom SJC kit built for the studio with beautiful wood shells on it. It's a 24 by 20 kick drum, so that thing's a freaking monster if you play doom metal. And then, of course, all the other fun kits. We have a Tama Grand Star Custom is the red kit. And that's a 7 or 8 piece kit by itself normally. And then, of course, the original Slingerland 20 by 18 floor tom. And then, of course, over here we have our incomplete vocal booth, which is holding the cat. Who got locked in here?
Huh? Oh, poor. She could have jumped through the window, though.
Did you take a nap? Oh, big stretch. Yep, took a nap in there, huh? This is Murray. Oh, you're very pleased with yourself. So, and of course, we have a few more of the custom cabs over here. This guy carries a couple of very vintage Mesa Black Shadow speakers and a Mesa Fillmore. So that's about as Mesa gets. And then, of course, we'll come into the beautiful live room.
Got some custom paintings on the wall.
And, of course, bass trapping everywhere, so the room is all nice and tuned, as you can hear. The viewers at home probably can't hear it as well, but you can see it all comes up. We have 20-foot tall chapel ceilings up in here, which is really, really great for drum sounds, and if you want really monster 80s guitars.
A wooded view of Bellevue.
Yes. We got lots of nature around here. And then, of course, last but not least, the amp head area. And that's pretty much the short and skinny 5-cent tour of the studio.
All right. The studio's, well, your whole lifetime in the making, but a year into it, you said?
Just about a year I've invested into start to finish. Everything is hand-built, hand-wired by me. So, yeah, it was a lot of time just spent in the garage making sort of random stuff like this. This is most of the journey is making bass traps and soldering wires. That's like 90% of the game, and punching wires. that's most of what I do. And then you don't really get to do any of the fun stuff until much, much later. So anybody that wants to get into this and do it the old school way, just be aware that it is very tedious. It is very, very hard to do, and it's very expensive. So I don't recommend it, but I do recommend that you come down here. We're going to be running an introductory special for new bands starting at $40 an hour for our block rates, and so we'll be able to get you in here. We have obviously full isolation of everything, so we'll be able to record the whole band live with 32 track, and then you don't even really need to bring your instruments. As you can see, you can pretty much just show up unless you're in some crazy electronica band or something, and then you might need to bring your instruments. But if you're just in doing rock and roll or metal, you could probably just show up.
Right on. Thanks a lot for showing us around, Sean.
Thanks so much.